All right, for our first example, we're going to kind of use the Hello World hardware, which is blinking an LED. The ST Micro Nucleo board has a few LEDs that are accessible here that are specific pins. And so what we're going to do is basically construct a Simulink model, set it up so that we can generate code to blink an LED on this development board. And we're going to do that using the support package approach. So before you are able to try any of this, the first thing you need to do is actually download a support package. So depending on the hardware you're trying to target, you need to download that hardware support package. From MATLAB here, you can actually do that from our add-on explorer. Go in here and you can search for the package of interest. So for example, in this case, we're working with the ST Nucleo processor. You'll see here I found the support package for that. I can select that. And then I already have it installed, but you would see an install button here. You could install it and then go through the setup process. That'll not only install the support package, but any kind of compiler or secondary kind of tools that are needed. Once you have that set up, let's go ahead and now build a Simulink model to actually blink this LED. So what we'll do is we'll go to Simulink. We'll actually just start from a blank model here. So we're going to start fully from scratch. And so what you can do is you could start adding blocks in here. You open up the Simulink library. We have kind of the base Simulink blocks. After installing a support package, you'll see I have some other support packages installed here for Texas Instruments, Raspberry Pi. You'll notice here I have my ST Microelectronics library. And here are the blocks that basically are the drivers associated with this board. So as I mentioned, if we want to control the pins, we have digital write, digital read. Now, before we start to drag and drop these blocks out into the Simulink model, Simulink is kind of a generic simulation and code generation tool. And so you can do a lot of different things. You can simulate electrical systems, mechanical systems, you can simulate algorithms, multiphysics. And so it's a very flexible tool. But if you know you're targeting a specific device, it's always good to tell Simulink that you're doing that and it's going to optimize things for you. And so what you can end up doing is go to our apps tab here. You'll see, depending on the tools that you have installed, a list of different apps. I will scroll down here to set up and run on hardware. And you'll see here I've got a link here to the support packages as well. But what I want to do is say run on hardware board. Okay, what I can do is now say select the hardware board. This is going to look at the support packages that I have installed and then allow me to select the board that I'm actually working with. And so you'll see I have a list of different tools here. In this case, the actual development board that I have is the Nucleo F767Zi. So this one right here. We can select that. And you'll notice this is it said under that code generation settings will be changed. So it's basically set up the code generation tool to target this board specifically. And so now we can start to add different blocks to represent blinking the LED. And so what we'll do is we will grab the digital write block. This is going to write a signal to a pin on the board. And then what we want to do is grab some kind of a signal. And so in this case, I'm just going to grab the pulse generator block. This creates basically a pulse on and off. If we kind of go into this block, a lot of these settings are kind of geared for just basic simulation. 10 seconds for on and off is a little bit long for visualization. So I'm going to go ahead and change that to 1. And then for my pulse width, I'll make it 50. So it's half a second off, half a second on. And we've got that set up. Say OK. Nextly, the block itself right now is just default to pin 0. What we need to do is look at what pin we want to actually map this to. And so if I go to our pin map here, this shows us the board itself and all of the different pins that we have here on our ST microprocessor. Okay, and so what we can do is kind of hunt down our LED. You'll see there's serial channels, PWM, analog in. And you'll see here LED1 is PB underscore 0. And so what we can do is type in PB underscore 0. And now when we convert this into code, this should write this pulse signal onto that pin, and we should see a blinking LED. Now, once we've got all of this set up, what we can do is make sure we're under the hardware tab. We can expand this out just a little bit. There's a couple of options. We'll come back to this one here in a second. But this button right here is how we actually convert to code. So there's the build button. This will basically just generate the code and compile it. this second button is actually going to build the code, deploy it directly to the processor using the compiler, and then start that code. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. And let's get the code generation process started. Okay. And I'll open up the diagnostics window so we can see the code gen process in action. Okay. And now this is complete, and we should be able to take a look at the blinking LED. As the code has been compiled and deployed, we can take a look at our LED. You'll notice right here, our LED is blinking on and off. So we have successfully generated the code and deployed it. So this is on and off, like we said, half a second on, half a second off. Now, the other button up here that we didn't discuss, monitor and tune, what this one will actually allow us to do is actually adjust the code as it's running on the target. So if, for example, these parameters here, pulse width or period, if we wanted to adjust the frequency of that PWM waveform, we could set this up to basically allow us to tune these on the fly. And so what we'll do is set this model up to do that process now. So the main thing you want to do is, of course, this is set up to do the pulsing of the signal here. What we need to do is also tell the tool how long we want this to run. I'll change it to infinite. And this uses a technique called external mode. So what we want to do is go into the hardware board settings here, external mode. And we just want to make sure that this serial port is set up correctly. So this is kind of one of those gotchas. And so the way that I can do that is go to my device manager. If I'm in Windows, and then go down to my ports. And we'll see that this ST-Link virtual COM port for the ST-Micro board is on COM4. So I can just change this from COM1 to COM4. And now what we can do is hit monitor and tune. So again, this is now going to generate the code. But in addition to the algorithm code to do the blinking LED, what this is going to do is add an additional interface, serial interface bit of code to keep a connection between Simulink and our target device and allow us to actually adjust parameters on the fly. So I can open up this CodeGen thing. We can take a look. So now what we'll see is that this has started model execution on the target. This code is now running. If we look back at the camera, we'll see that our LED is blinking again right here. And it's blinking at a rate of on and off of half a second. Now, what I can do is I can go back to my Simulink model. Right now, my pulse generator, again, is turning on and off every half a second. I can maybe change this to... We'll see that it's slower. So this allows me to tune things kind of live.